You're now tuned in to the Real Money Coach broadcast with host Tony Jackson, author of the book Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money. Get ready for winning tips and strategies to effectively manage your finances and learn the key principles of protecting and dominating your money. Now, here's author and host Tony Jackson.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome to the Real Money Coach Show. I am your host, Tony Jackson, and it is awesome to be with you on another Saturday morning. I love it. Thank you all for listening to the show each and every week. Man, that just excites me. And you know what I would like doing most of all is just getting good content, good information out to the listeners. Make sure that you know that you're invited to come watch the live show on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern. Asking, and I'll remind you again later in the show at some point, to subscribe to our YouTube channel because we want to get the number of subscribers up. And so all those type of things are just, you know, just an exciting time, really. And, you know, in the first couple days of summer here, and pretty exciting. I had a great weekend last weekend at the MBN Millionaire Mindset Conference. I was tired, y'all, afterwards because, I mean, two late nights, and it was a great event. So kudos to all the organizers, Stan Matthews, the owner, and, of course, my mentor was here, Dr. Frazier. I got to spend some time with him on Tuesday. We went to City Hall, met our city manager, talked about the Power Networking Conference, which will be here in North Carolina for 3 years, 2024, 25, and 26. So a lot of great things happening. I want to talk about something. I want to kind of bring this full circle. And it's kind of interesting. There's been some things that have happened in the sports and entertainment world that really Charlotte, the Queen City, has kind of been in the center of much, a lot of it. And let me just kind of go back to 2001, Bob Johnson, the founder of BET, sells BET for $3 billion. $3 billion. Bob Johnson becomes the first African-American billionaire in the country when he sells BET to Viacom. And so BET was no longer black owned. So that was in 2001. How it relates to Charlotte is that Bob Johnson then buys what was then known as the Charlotte Bobcats in 2003 for $300 million. That's only 10% of the money that he made from BET, by the way. So he buys the professional NBA basketball team, becomes the first majority owner of an NBA franchise. 2003, buys the Charlotte Bobcats for $300 million, becomes the owner, and that's where it's related to Charlotte. Now, he has a lot of other businesses here as well, but that was the big deal, right? So now, even though BET is not black-owned anymore, we have now a majority black-owned NBA franchise. In 2010, he sells the Charlotte Hornets to what many people call the GOAT, Michael Jordan. So Michael Jordan buys the Bobcats, or the Hornets then, from Bob Johnson for $275 million. The Bobcats, you guys, have been, or the Hornets, have been minority black owned. Let's like not even say minority. Let's say black owned for 20 years. Now, coming full circle, we saw that BET was sold 22 years ago, no longer black owned. Reportedly, last week, Tyler Perry buys BET. So now BET becomes black owned again. And we don't know exactly. We do know this. We do know that Tyler Perry was already 25% owner of BET, but now he's the owner. And I've heard different numbers, 400 million. I've heard $3 billion was the asking price. Don't know where all that landed, but I was on, I do know some people that were on a conference call, a Zoom call or something that you know, that announcement was made. So Tyler Perry, now BET is black owned again. Well, then last week, Michael Jordan sells the Charlotte Hornets. And so Charlotte Hornets is no longer a black owned franchise. And so he sells it for $1.7 billion. What an investment. Remember, I said that he bought it for what? $275 million, sells it for $1.7 billion. And, you know, and now here's the thing. I wanted to kind of talk about a few of the owners that you might know, because they're still, even though it's not majority black owned anymore, you have J. Cole, who is one of the minority owners with the new organization that's buying it. You have a couple other names, Eric Church. I believe he's a country singer. Amy Levine Dawson of the Levine family here in Charlotte is one of the minority owners. And a gentleman that you need to know about, Damian Mills, is also one of the minority owners. Damian Mills is one of the largest black-owned dealership owners in the country. He has over 29 dealerships that he owns, including a new Porsche dealership that's going to open in North Lake. He's the owner of that. He is a billionaire that is in our backyard. And so he's one of the minority owners. So even though we're no longer totally owned, minority controlled in terms of the Charlotte Hornets, there are still some people like J. Cole, Damian Mills, who are minority owners. So, man, to me, it just seems like full circle, you know, from BET being sold and then being bought and all this. The Hornets being the first majority-owned black NBA franchise to now it's sold. Wow, a lot going on. But listen, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to come back with a great interview with Marvin Wilson. He is the owner of Lendio. Lendio is a business lending company, as well as many other things. Many of you may know him from his ticket sales business that he had back in the day. So we'll take a quick break and I'll come back with this interview with Marvin Wilson. You're listening to The Real Money Coach Show. I'm your host, Tony Jackson.
Bigger than the universe. You're bigger than the sun and the stars. You're bigger than the things, oh, that could tear me apart. You're bigger than the universe. You're bigger than the sun and the stars. You're bigger than the things, oh my, oh my, that could tear me apart. For I
join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
This is Tony Jackson, The Real Money Coach. I use my deep understanding of personal financial principles and 25 years of experience to educate my clients and empower them to make informed financial decisions. I dive into the emotional and psychological aspects of money to help them uncover their own beliefs and behavior. I provide practical strategies through personalized coaching to overcome financial challenges, build wealth, and achieve financial goals. To schedule your complimentary session with me, go to therealmoneycoach.com. I'm Tony Jackson. I'm the Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
Welcome back. Welcome back to the Real Money Coach show here on Praise 100.9 in every place that you get your podcast. As I mentioned to you in the first part of the show, I have my friend, my colleague, in the person of Marvin Wilson in the studio with me, and I'm so excited. Now, let me tell you something. Marvin is a vet. You know, I think the Navy, right, man? The Navy.
Yeah,
Navy.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. He launched Carolina's first banking franchise in Lendio Central Charlotte.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just part of what he does. And I don't want to take it away. I want you to hear straight from him who Marvin Wilson is. Marvin, thank you for being in the studio this morning.
Hey, man. Glad to be here, Tony. Definitely, man. It's been a long time.
Yeah, man. We've been talking about this for a while. And so now the day has come.
It's here.
And we're here going to share some great information with the people, the listeners out there. So, man, tell everybody a little bit about who you are, your background, kind of how you got to where you are right now.
Interesting story. I might keep it short. I'm a native, a Carolinian man. I'm actually from a small town right up the street, Salisbury, North Carolina. Big ups to Salisbury. Went in the military at 17, got out, you know, ventured into doing a little bit of veteran stuff at the Pentagon, doing a lot of stuff like that. But I don't know, man. I got that entrepreneur bug. And I just wanted to see what this looked like. And first thing, jumped into travel and entertainment. And most people really, Tony, sort of, that was my moment of really just capturing the stage, if you will, and brought a lot of aspects into the city, CIAA and things of that sort. And that was my claim of fame for a while.
So you were kind of a promoter and well, brought things in?
I don't want to downplay promoters out here, but no. No, I was not a promoter. It was something that really I feel that is a piece of me of all what I've always, God's given me a gift of being able to see an area, and it was corporate ticketing.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
It was like ticketing. It was like, it was sort of like the urban version of Ticketmaster.
Gotcha.
Right?
Gotcha.
So I had ticketing modules inside of convention centers, and I had ticketing systems that was connected to CIAA parties.
Got it.
People could actually go online back then, and that was amazing for 2010.
Right.
To actually be able to buy tickets, VIP tickets and things of that sort. So anyway, it was great. We made a great big deal out of it. CIAA really was something that was huge. So with that, and I have to always say the pros and cons, because that's just a part of the journey, in about 6 years of really just killing it, going all over the country, doing NBA All-Star, a lot of things. This big $800 million gorilla came in the room and said, all right, time's over. And that was Eventbrite.
Mm.
It shut us down.
Okay.
But with that, had to really go and do some due diligence and self-inventory on where I was in life, man, because I thought that was going to be, you know, my thing.
Right.
And with that, I said, you know what? Let me go out and let me see what this finance world's about, because a lot of that took place that we couldn't get to, because we had some things going on with tickets. But one thing about tickets, you can sell all the tickets you want, but if you don't have the place of where the tickets are being sold at, the venue.
Right.
Ticketmaster got the buildings and the tickets.
Yeah, so they got it all.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
Talking about Eventbrite, man. Ticketmaster.
Was real. Now Eventbrite still, because you know they're giving people that concept of, hey, like Facebook, like this is my Facebook page.
Right, right.
But of course that's not your page, because they could shut you down any time. But at the end of the day, Eventbrite gives you that more of that vision of being able to really do a lot of things, you know, independently.
Yeah, create your own event, your own ticketing and all that. So man, I knew something, man, because, you know, we met in the parking lot, and I'm walking through the building. You know more people up in here than I do. I'm like, so you know, I'm like, okay, this guy, you know, this is Marvin Wilson.
Yeah.
This is Marvin Wilson. So so that kind of explains you kind of were in that entertainment industry and all those type of things and doing that.
And the thing is, Tony, just to bring it back to it, man, to bring me here, it's technology, man. It's technology. Technology would change the whole atmosphere of ticketing, and it's changing the whole atmosphere of finance, you know. And in the background, people thinking that it's just some guy back there that could be racist or something that's disapproving your loans. But it's really just automation and things that just have to be, you have to have certain things in certain places to get certain things, you know, and, you know, it's interesting.
So you kind of had to reinvent yourself from the ticketing industry to now, with commercial lending, small business lending, that type of thing.
And I did, man. It was interesting. It was a whole year. Again, I had to really, you know, and it's in my book. Check it out on Amazon, guys. Passion for Freedom. I talk about it because I want people to really learn from my journey, Tony. A lot of people want to put all the accolades and all this stuff. I'm like, hey, man, this stuff put me back on my mom's couch in my 30s. That's humbling, right?
Oh,
that's humbling.
That's humbling.
Yeah.
I didn't know you had the book, man.
Yeah, I got the book, bro.
Passion
for Freedom. Go
on
get
Amazon,
it, man.
And
I, you know, I had to go out and do the due diligence. But I was back out there within a year. You know, I took my last little 10 grand and really just went out, Tone, and went to networking, land on a lot of other places, and just learned the business and credit world.
Okay.
And just self-taught and just talked to the right people and got myself, you know, in some brick and mortars here, and funding credit was birthed.
Well, listen, we're going to take a quick break here in a second, and we're going to come back. I want to unpack a little bit of that. And those of you who follow my show know that whoever's my guest here on Saturday morning will be the guest on the live show come Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern time. And I want to make sure everyone who listening, all y'all, I need you to go to YouTube. I need you to go to YouTube. The Real Money Coach, I need you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you'll be notified when we go live. And actually, YouTube is a little bit more reliable than our Facebook Live. If you go to the YouTube, that's the best way to catch our show. And we're going to take a quick break, and I'm coming back, and we're going to have more information. This dude just told y'all he ended up on his mother's couch at age 30, and he made it back. That's good news for all of us, no matter where you're at right now. You can do it. You're listening to The Real Money Coach Show. I'm your host, Tony Jackson. We'll be right back.
Join author Tony Jackson for the Real Money Coach broadcast each and every Saturday morning from 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9. Mr. Jackson enlightens you on the real secrets of money. He'll also help you increase, protect, and dominate your money. You can also catch Tony Jackson's The Real Money Coach every Tuesday at 8 p.m. on Facebook Live and YouTube. Check out The Real Money Coach, Mr. Tony Jackson, every Saturday morning, 7:30 a.m. to 8 a.m. on Praise 100.9.
This is Tony Jackson, The Real Money Coach. I use my deep understanding of personal financial principles and 25 years of experience to educate my clients and empower them to make informed financial decisions. I dive into the emotional and psychological aspects of money to help them uncover their own beliefs and behavior. I provide practical strategies through personalized coaching to overcome financial challenges, build wealth, and achieve financial goals. To schedule your complimentary session with me, go to therealmoneycoach.com. I'm Tony Jackson. I'm The Real Money Coach.
And welcome back to The Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson.
Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to The Real Money Coach Show. I'm your host, Tony Jackson. Now, I also want to remind you that you can catch this show and all of my shows on wherever you get your podcast, and whether that's Apple, whether that's Google. I always joke because my mama liked Pandora, and whether it's Pandora, wherever you're getting your podcast, you can get this show and let everybody you know that they can come and listen to us on demand on all podcasting platforms. So I'm still in the studio with a boy here, Marvin Wilson, and we're just talking a little bit about his experience and what he's been through and what he's overcome. And, you know, people are overcome by our testimony, right? Yeah. So, and it's so interesting, Marvin, that everybody wants a testimony, but they don't want the test.
Thank you. The test
comes first,
preach,
right?
Brother,
the
preach.
Test comes first, and then the rest. You know, so it's like you see the story, but you don't know the history,
the
right?
History,
you don't know what I've been through.
Thank you.
And man, you don't look like what you've been through, man. You sitting up in this, you're sitting up in my studio, ear all sharp, man.
Yeah.
And so, and y'all, I'm just having a good time with Marvin this morning. So, man, let's talk a little bit about lending and talk a little bit about what you're doing in that area. And you know, one of the things I know that's big, right? I'm seeing on social media is AI. You know, people talking about using AI to, you know, fix your credit, AI this. And we know biases also can be built into AI, right?
Mm-hmm,
so, but let's talk a little bit about it, man. Give me a little perspective on the lending side of things.
Yeah, man. I mean, you know, it's all about, you know, I mean, I always just talk to people on side of most people traditionally go for lending and funding from banks. Right.
Yeah.
So let's just say via us being banks, we always got to understand and go, is you going to be a business owner? You're going to just open up a personal loan. Banks are not set up. They're not set up to lose. They don't lose. Okay.
Right.
And you know that being an insurance guy. Right.
They don't
lose. So, you know, FDIC is insurance in those letters. Okay.
Right.
And so with being said, guys, is that credibility. One, you got to have some credit, whether it be personal or business. And you're either going to have revenue, rather have some type of substantial money coming through that account or money in that bank. Or thirdly is collateral, meaning that if you don't pay, we can take it back. You know, something, you give me some land, give me a home, give me something that you own. And, you know, but that's just the game that's played. But at the end of the day, there's so many different areas that we can really go out here and exercise and leverage those means and be able to really be, go out and, you know, create dreams, man, and really live this life of way it's supposed to be lived. And I say, you know, being in the lending world, I had to learn the credit and learn how business is supposed to be set up and how to be leveraged to go out here to even ask for funding. It's like a fundability report. So with that being said, just to step into funding, you know, most of my applications and criteria before we even talk to people is, what is your credit score? You know, a lot of people don't even know their credit score. A lot of people don't even know, are you a seasoned business? Well, what's it considered to be a seasoned business? Have you been in business for 5 years? You know, did you know it changed from 3 to 5 years since COVID? Do you know that, you know, a lot of lending institutions now are, you know, doing credit check. Not only are they doing credit check, they're doing background checks. Okay. Did you know there are other than three, there's more than three bureaus, Equifax, TransUnion, And Experian, no, there's LexisNexis, you know. There's, you know, there's cyber. There's a lot of different categories and data that's on us that makes decisions when it comes to lending, right?
So, man, you mentioned even the background check and that type mm-hmm. of thing. What about social media? Is there any, like, looking at social media and saying, hey, you know, especially in the business, sure. right? Because we talk about the five C's of lending, you mm-hmm. know, credit, collateral. I think character, mm-hmm. right? Yep. Character,
yep.
right?
Yep.
So is that being done at all?
It's crucial. And I think that a lot of people learned about more when it comes to the status or the sense of having some type of media platform or presence. I don't know a lot of people out there, definitely when y'all heard about the EIDL and all the PPP and things like that. Well, they were right. crucial, man. I mean, if you didn't have a social media presence, you wouldn't get in the loan.
Mm.
So really what they're telling us is that, yeah, we are looking at you. We're looking at you personally. We're looking at you from business. Are you telling us the truth? Do you have the type of, you know, I mean, if I'm going to give you $100,000 and you're saying you're doing an expansion, then why you only have 2 likes? You know, yeah, why on, should, man. You know, no, I mean, hey,
I mean, but that's real talk.
It's real talk.
It's real
yeah.
talk because, you know, sometimes we criticize kids now, right? Because mm-hmm. we say, you know, everybody's going for likes. They just want to see how many likes they have. But you just told me that there's a critical reason to have some likes if you look at you know, business lending,
yeah.
business credit.
Yeah, yeah. yeah.
Wow.
I mean, it's just a level of, you know, where you're putting yourself at. You know, you can sell the story to, you know, your friends or your people or the people you hang out with, but when it really gets down to the people that's behind the data and the mm-hmm. people you're asking monetary means and funding for, they're looking at it like, okay, this guy is asking me for 200 grand. He's telling me that he can pay me back and da 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 da. And I'm seeing two people, one testimony, he hadn't posted something in the last 6 or 7 months. Like, where is this coming from? I might need to ask this guy a few other more additional questions, you know?
Wow.
And usually when they do that, they find something that really doesn't work in the people's favor.
So when they start, you don't want them digging.
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 Man, listen, I can't believe this. We're just about out of time. And this is, those of you listening, this is exactly why I format the show the way I do, because we have a short time here on Saturday morning. But what you need to do is come back on Tuesday at 8 when I'll have 45 minutes to sit down with this lending expert that can help us help you get funding for your business
yep.
and our goal is this. Our goal is to put you on the right track. Mm-hmm. Our goal is to put you on the right track. And if you're not lendable, to get you to a place where you are lendable.
Right. Absolutely.
So, yep. So Mark, real quick, how can people get in touch with you if they wanted to get in touch with you?
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely. You can go to in the funding credits on LinkedIn, you know, Instagram. You can go to funding-credit.com. That hyphen is crucial, funding-credit.com. And, you know, I have some YouTube. I got some, you know, some videos and things like that. Of course, funding credits, all that. And then, of course, Lendio CLT, of course, is which the fintech lending model.
There it is. So make sure y'all tell Mama and them, Uncle Bubba, June, tell them all to dial in on Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Time for the Real Money Coach Show. I'm your host, Tony Jackson. I'm out. Y'all have a great weekend.
We hope you've enjoyed the Real Money Coach broadcast with author and host, Tony Jackson. We encourage you to utilize today's strategies and principles to manage your money in the most effective and winning way. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to send us an email, Tony Jackson Agency @gmail.com, or you can reach us on all social media platforms. And if you would like a copy of Tony Jackson's book, Increase, Protect, and Dominate Your Money, log on to www.therealmoneycoach.com. Until next week's empowering broadcast, God bless.